بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. السلام علیکم. ویلکم ٹو اندر انٹرسٹنگ سیشن آن انٹروڈکشن ٹو اوریکل کلاؤڈ سروسز. ٹوڈے ول ٹرائی ٹو کور انسٹالیشن آف اوریکل لائنکس ورچوئل مشین انڈر کمپیوٹ. دا ایجنڈا وڈ بی کریٹ اے 7.7 اوریکل لائنکس مشین ورچوئل مشین and creating SSH key using PuttyGen. It's a small utility, both private and public, and login to OS using OPC user, then getting access as root user. Okay, let's start. Sorry, after login to your virtual machine, cloud account, on the top left you have this under compute, create a virtual machine. Okay, by default Oracle Linux 7.7 is selected. I will not change anything. Whatever is the default, I will keep as default. It's one core, single core, CPU, 15 GB RAM. I'm not changing anything over here, and we'll move down to my SSH key. Okay, I have installed KeyGen. This is PuttyGen. Okay, a few things. By default, SSH 2 RSA key should be enabled. If not, select it. Down RSA should be there, and then here 2048, right? I will show you how to generate, and here you have to move your mouse in order it to get random values. So now this is generated. Now I will save as private key. Yes, and you can put your name and save it as a PPK extension. PPK, right? I have already saved, so I'm not saving again. And secondly, select this key. Don't skip any character, it should be complete whole key. And control C, open your notepad, and in this control V, then file, save as. Put your name, and then here you must select all files, otherwise it will put extension .txt, and you have to manually put .pub pub extension. This is must, right? Now next is, once you will save these two files, you remember the path. So since I have already saved, so I will not create again to avoid duplication. I will just choose here. I had saved with private key underscore training dot pub. Select. It is selected now, and create. That's it. Okay. Let me see what it's showing. If I move down, it is in progress. You can note down the time. It is 10:03 PM. So we'll see the progress. Okay, meanwhile, let me show you something under compute. So this is on the top, it is getting created. Still it is provisioning. Okay, I will show you from the start. Let me go to my home. I will again create. I wanted to show you something. Additional images, how you can select. Okay, and while creating this one, you can choose other images. So let's say, for example, different Linux versions are here, right? 7.6, 6.10, and whatever. Then you have Oracle images as well, Oracle database, or Vision instance of 12.2.8, demo install image. It's free, you can install, and other tools. Here price BYOU by your own license. So here license is not available. You will bring your license and you can provision the same. Okay, there are different Oracle Linux 8, it's free and different, right? PeopleSoft, Siebel, CRM, whatever. And you can move forward if you have any requirement. These are again by partners. So partners has uploaded, I will say, with Oracle or Oracle Cloud. So you can install, but still you need to buy licenses from them and then you can use it. And here these are free, whatever they are. You can have Windows Server as well. It is under here, if you see here, right? So just wanted to show you that these options are available. So even you can have custom images, if any, which you can install from here, right? So this is how you can install from image. Let us see about the status of our instance. So I will go to compute and instance. It's running. So let me click here. Let me hide these the terminated ones I had created earlier for some testing. So I will say only running. So it will show me only my instance, right? Let me click it over here. If you see here, you can have further information, its versions, other details, right? Its utilization, memory utilization, CPU utilization, disk write IO, disk read byte, disk write bytes, etc. Network receiver, different charts, right? Okay. On the top, you can manage, you can stop, you can do whatever you want, right? Reboot. You can assign tags just to identify your search. Okay. Now, if you see here, primary VNIC information. Okay. This is private IP address. Private will be within cloud. So, this you will not be able to access remotely. So, this is, let's say, for example, if you have two machines, you have to access within your Oracle Cloud. So, you can access using this. This is our public IP address. So now we are going to use it to access this server, right? Just copy this one. And then you open PuTTY. It is here with me. Just click here and then enter here. Under PuTTY, you have to come under SH and click AUTH. Then on the right, private key file for authorization. So you have to browse. Okay. And here I will say private. I had created this. Now this time you will not select PUB, you will select this PPK, right? And open, right? I have selected this file and now I will click open, right? Click yes here. So login as what? OPC is the default user. Okay, now you are logged in. Who am I? Right? LS DF minus H. So you have the access. You can check the spaces. Okay, now from here, if we have to switch to our root user. So now I will show you how to work as a root. So you will not log in as a root from your machine, you will log in as OPC, then you will switch to root user. Sudo su, any root level or supervisory access you can use, you have to use sudo sudo. Okay, if you see on the left side, now I am logged in as root. So now this is root user. Okay, who am I? Right, when I will exit it, it will be come back to OPC, right? That's it. Now in this you can do your installation whatever you want. Operating system is ready. I hope, if I'm not wrong, the whole process creating, generating this SSH key, it took less than 5 minutes. Less than 5 minutes, which I believe in other cases, let's say if you have to purchase hardware as well, it will be very tough, right? So this is how it is. Okay, let me stop it, or I can terminate it. Okay, so I hope it is clear now. So let me terminate now this instance. Okay, sorry, you have some informations over here, let's say OCID show, or you can copy while reporting to Oracle, or you know, sometime if you have to create SR with Oracle, so they will ask you information, what are the information. So this is how it is. I'm sure you liked it, how quick and fast it is to get a Linux machine in less than 5 minutes, I will say, right? Okay, let me remove it, terminate, permanently remove, terminate. That's it. It will now remove the session instance of the Linux. Okay, right? If you have any further question, okay, another thing is I would like to share here on our portal erpstuff.com/forums. We have this section. I'm sure it will be interesting thing for you. Let me go back to my home. If you go down on the tabs in the different forums, if you see here, we have Oracle Service Cloud. So you can come here. There will be different topics shared over here, and links and support or whatever. So if you see this, the top one, which is pinned one, it is showing you how to create your free Oracle Cloud account. So there are steps over here. You can perform these steps. The way I created, this is my free account, by the way. Let me show you here. Okay, let me click here. So by default, in the free demo, I will say account, Oracle is giving €250 for 1 month. So I have to use within 1 month, 30 days. I use this balance, or balance is not used, but 30 days is done. So after 30 days, it will expire. It needs credit card information, but there will be no charge during 30 days for or up to 250. But if you want to continue, you have to agree, and then you can continue. Otherwise, it will not automatically charge your credit card, right? I hope so. We have covered this now. So thank you very much for going through the video. Allah Hafiz.